Well, the inaugural stage is set for President-elect Donald Trump's inauguration this Friday, but many protesters, thousands of them, apparently putting their plans in place for big disruptions.
But one motorcycle group has vowed to protect attendees by riding down to Washington to support the president-elect.
And joining us right now is the founder of the group, Bikers for Trump, Chris Cox. Chris, why do you think we need, Americans need a wall of bikers to protect the inauguration?
Well, first, let me explain to your bikers. To me, the definition of a biker is a patriot who is a motorcycle enthusiast. Okay. Bikers are citizen crusaders from across the country. They're from all walks of life. And Hollywood would have us to believe that they are renegade outlaws. That's just not the case. And many times, bikers have reached the top of their field. For instance, Keith Schiller, Donald Trump's chief of security, is a motorcycle enthusiast. Mm-hmm. We got Kyle Petty, who travels the country raising millions of dollars each year. Franklin Graham, Hank himself, is a biker. He takes a trip from North Carolina to Alaska every year. So this demographic is blue collar as well as white collar.
Surely.
And so to answer your question, you know, our narrative has changed. And when we were in Cleveland, we certainly were there to stand toe-to-toe against those who would cause chaos and mayhem, and to stand with law enforcement. But the times have changed, and people have learned a lot since all these disruptions in Arizona and in Chicago. So we're anticipating a peaceful transfer of action, of power here. And so we don't have any reason to believe that we're going to have any problems. A lot of times the media polarizes things that are coming up, just like they did in Cleveland. So in the event that we are needed, yes, we're going to be there. But we'd like to talk about the people who have come together collectively to support Donald Trump and to just come to Washington, D.C. to celebrate this event.
Well, it's You know, Chris, pardon the interruption. There are something like 1,000 buses of protesters being bused down to Washington right now as we speak through the next 5 days. If something happens, what is your group prepared to do?
Well, that remains to be seen. First and foremost, we're going to give law enforcement every opportunity to do their job. We're going to leave it to guys a little smarter than us when it comes to security. In the event that we have guys coming up and assaulting us and you know, what people don't understand is a lot of these anarchists that are coming in town, they don't like us any more than they like the Democrats, any more than they like that these women are going to be marching and going to be protesting. They don't like either one of us. We may find ourselves trying to help fortify an area where some of these women that are protesting Donald Trump. Wow. As patriots, we have to keep an eye on everybody, all citizens. And we think Donald Trump would have us keep an eye on everybody.
All right. Chris Cox, Bikers for Trump. We wish you all the best. Thank you so much for coming on our show, Chris.
Thank you, everybody. Hitting a peaceful transfer of action, of power here. And so we don't have any reason to believe that we're going to have any problems. A lot of times the media polarizes things that are coming up, just like they did in Cleveland. So in the event that we are needed, yes, we're going to be there. But we'd like to talk about the people who have come together collectively to support Donald Trump and to just come to Washington, D.C. to celebrate this event.
Well, it's You know, Chris, pardon the interruption. There are something like 1,000 buses of protesters being bused down to Washington right now as we speak through the next 5 days. If something happens, what is your group prepared to do?
Well, that remains to be seen. First and foremost, we're going to give law enforcement every opportunity to do their job. We're going to leave it to guys a little smarter than us when it comes to security. In the event that we have guys coming up and assaulting us and, you know, what people don't understand is a lot of these anarchists that are coming in town, they don't like us any more than they like the Democrats, any more than they like that these women are going to be marching and going to be protesting. They don't like either one of us. Your bikers, to me, the definition of a biker is a patriot who is a motorcycle enthusiast. Okay. Bikers are citizen crusaders from across the country. They're from all walks of life. And Hollywood would have us to believe that they are renegade outlaws. That's just not the case. And many times, bikers have reached the top of their field. For instance, Keith Schiller, Donald Trump's chief of security, is a motorcycle enthusiast. Mm-hmm. We got Kyle Petty, who travels the country raising millions of dollars each year. Franklin Graham, Hank himself, is a biker. He takes a trip from North Carolina to Alaska every year. So this demographic is blue collar as well as white collar.
Surely.
And so to answer your question, you know, our narrative has changed. And when we were in Cleveland, we certainly were there to stand toe-to-toe against those who would cause chaos and mayhem, and to stand with law enforcement. But the times have changed, and people have learned a lot since all these disruptions in Arizona and in Chicago. So we're anticipating.
Well, the inaugural stage is set for President-elect Donald Trump's inauguration this Friday, but many protesters, thousands of them, apparently putting their plans in place for big disruptions.
But one motorcycle group has vowed to protect attendees by riding down to Washington to support the president-elect.
And joining us right now is the founder of the group, Bikers for Trump, Chris Cox. Chris, why do you think we need, Americans need a wall of bikers to protect the inauguration?
Well, first, let me explain.